You are not getting an assistant to fuck. You are getting a new nigga. Downgrading ass bitch. Remember she showed up with that little boy that was like 19? And that nigga's a full-fledged killer. And she had that nigga out there on motherfucking red carpets and shit with a bow tie on. If you don't get 17 felonies the fuck up out of the Littlefoot motherfucking premiere, you cross the line. Don't believe in Jesus ass bitch. Truthfully, that's why I fucking left her. The bitch is a goddamn atheist. I told her for God I was the king of the niggas. This bitch said I don't believe in God or niggas. I said, bitch, if you don't get your satanic, demonic, I want to be a cracker in the face ass up out of here, bitch, I will call down the ghost of Sojourner Truth to walk up your motherfucking street. What in the Harriet Tubman is this light-skinned and ugly bitch talking about? How the fuck is you light-skinned and ugly? Not ugly to nobody else, bitch. Nobody said, bitch, Hazel Lee was ugly while I was fucking the bitch. Soon as I leave the bitch, suddenly her nose is crooked. She got an under and an overbite. The bitch is in Dubai getting shit on. I love it. I love it, bitch. Hey, fellas, if your woman go to Dubai, you know how cleanliness is next to godliness? Well, say goodbye to that bitch. Dubai. They giving them bitches 10 racks to shit on them. And I ain't never shit on a woman, not a day in my life. I'm not too big to shit on a woman. If you like that sort of thing, ladies, hit my DM if you like to be shit on.
I told you he was throwing shots. Shit. Now, I was really surprised at Cat Williams' insecurity just bleeding through the live stream, okay? Because there's a lot of shit he really didn't explain, although he did give away a lot of reasons as to why he's currently not feeling his light-skinned and ugly ex because of the little boy that she traded him in for. Once he bought that house, that car, and all of those jewels that she wearing, and this little boy who ain't got no job, she got him from somewhere in the hood, allegedly he gay or something, and she moved him in shortly after her and Cat Williams ended up breaking up. She broke up with him. She said she wasn't trying to catch no federal charges because apparently she's being questioned or has been questioned by the feds regarding his finances. And then she didn't like the episode of the SWAT team busting inside of his house, demanding everybody to get on the ground for a warrant that he had out for his arrest. I don't know what he did. I don't care. He has so many damn felonies while he's trying to call out this little boy that she replaced because he looked like a younger version of Cat Williams. He was just mad that he put the house in her name and paid for cash, and now he can't lay up with his light skin and ugly ass ex-girlfriend, okay? Now, I'm very surprised that Cat Williams allowing his insecurities to bleed, okay? I mean, he's done it before, but not to this degree. Because surprisingly, back in 2016, he was singing a different tune. Basically said that she was his ride chick and that all of his relationships are real. Take a look, his own damn words.
But Hazel, yeah, I'm always gonna love Hazel because all of my relationships are real relationships.
Mm-hmm. Cat said, real love, ay. I'm searching for a real love, ay. That's what it was then, and that's exactly what it is now, because don't nobody just get on live talking about no old shit just out of the blue. He was really in his feelings because he bought her $1 million home, bought her a car, bought her all this jewelry, and she said, forget him, he sweat too much, in bed, pounding too fast. I got all that I needed, and I ain't got no home loan because he has never, according to Kat, ever got a loan from a bank, okay? So he paid for that house cash, okay? Good move for the light-skinned and ugly chick. Looking just like this damn WikiLeaks mask right here. Now, all of this this started primarily because Hazel E has been posting pictures of her in Dubai, okay? And I guess somebody said it to Kat on the live stream, and he basically said that Hazel E is allegedly out there in Dubai getting shitted on, okay, for 10 racks. And I'm thinking to myself, if she did go to Dubai and get shitted on, because she was in Dubai when she actually broke her nose on that, I guess that ATV out there in them sands and shit, and he ended up paying for that nose job. You remember that big ass nose? It was actually able to break. I thought the bigger the nose, the more cushion, just like mine and shit. But she was in Dubai and actually broke her nose. So I'm wondering, after she got the plastic surgery that he paid for to fix her nose, because she was on Love & Hip Hop Hollywood explaining that he fixed her nose, and she was laying up in the house that he had bought her cash, I wondered if he licked that shit and pissed right off of her. As soon as she came back, because I know he got his payment back in vagina after he dumped some money on that new nose. He wasn't trying to hear no excuses about your nose being broken. You was gonna give him some head if he wanted it. You better put your nose to the side when you down there, because he don't want to hear no excuses about no painful shit. I know exactly that's what he told her when she was giving him head when her nose was broken and shit. But I wonder if he licked that shit and pissed. He did. And that's why he's mad about it. But you know what? Truth be told, I was watching some little girl on YouTube years ago, and she was basically stating that these girls do go out there and get prostituted, especially if you're a black woman. She said these sheiks and shit, they love black women, and they don't mind throwing them a few racks if they could just piss on them and do the shit that they can't do to their wives. And so she said in the video, man, I wish I could find that damn video. And if I do, I'll link it below. I'll let you know on the community feed, okay? She said that she couldn't even go to a damn nightclub in Dubai without getting approached by the Arabs, and they would just outright ask for some pussy. She said that black women, especially light-skinned and ugly women, made it bad for her, and she really couldn't enjoy the country that she was in because a lot of the men there expected the black women, especially if they were beautiful and they were dressed a certain way, to offer certain services. So she said she wasn't taking her ass back over there. I ain't going to no goddamn Arab country. I don't give a shit how exotic it looks. We ain't got no damn business over there, and I ain't damn going, because their laws are different, okay? Now, Cat Williams can continue to deny his strong feelings for Hazel E, because don't nobody just go out and just drop cash on a house on someone that he's only been with for less than a year, because she got that house within 7 months, right around the time that she got a nose fixed. What if she really didn't get into a crash and broke her nose? What if one of them sheiks just kicked her ass in that goddamn nose when he was shitting on her? I don't know. I hope that ain't what happened. But Cat Williams' insecurities definitely came through that camera, because this woman was more than just a jump off, okay? You don't spend this type of money and you don't come in her and get her pregnant, and then she has a miscarriage and you're weeping over that miscarriage as well, because you wanted something more with this light-skinned and ugly woman. Now, speaking of that damn comment, okay, I had a lot of problems with that comment, because we do have light-skinned and ugly women walking around looking like this, okay? But just because they have light skin, it's men like Cat Williams that do lay out, buy them houses, buy them cars, but as soon as they get done wrong, now all of a sudden you light-skinned and ugly, okay? I'm just sick and tired of men using skin color as a way to uplift and make a woman feel less than, okay? It ain't got nothing to do with the skin color. He just mad that that light-skinned and ugly that look just like this WikiLeaks mask and shit ended up taking his money, okay? So now he wanna bring the skin color in this shit and don't want to bring his lack of goods in it, okay? Because if Kat was really all of that, we wouldn't see him on IG Live bleeding with insecurities about what this woman is doing with a man that ain't got no money, and she got this man laying up in a house that he bought. That's why he's really mad. He's mad that he honestly has to dish out this kind of cash to get women that he puts on a pedestal that are light-skinned. And I'm glad she did his ass wrong, because it's not about the damn skin color. It's honestly about the character. Everybody knew what type of chick Hazel E was. Any bitch that would sleep with a nigga named Young Berg, you know she ain't got no damn standards. And so when he got her, he thought that he would be able to supplement her with money, because he couldn't supplement her in other areas, and that's why Cat really ain't got no main woman that he can call his woman, because he's too busy out here lacking in goods. And not only is he lacking in goods, he's snorting and it's making him come too quick, okay? So that's why they taking his money and he having to give up his money in exchange for the love that he thinks he had. He think Hazel E had a damn miscarriage. That hoe ain't had no miscarriage. She just didn't want to be tied to his short, coming up short ass, and that's why she was able to sit that shitty vagina on his face, look down at him, tell him that she love him and shit, get a house because she knew that $1 million was $100 to his ass, and dip and move a younger nigga in there who can't nearly afford give her what she want because she's so used to messing with these dudes that ain't got no money named Young Bird, okay? And that are allegedly gay. Now, So I think, yes, we saw a little insecurity, a little narcissism, all the above in Cat Williams because he mad that that light-skinned and ugly woman that looked just like this WikiLeaks mask, he just mad that he was her damn trick. Now, but he ain't gonna tell that on the video, okay? And frankly, I'm glad this shit happened to her because anybody that thinks that just because somebody is light-skinned, that makes them a great person on the inside, that's why his ass is on IG Live crying right now, and I really don't give two shits, okay? But it's men like him that honestly has Hazel E out here writing posts like this, saying that black women can't pass a damn paper bag test and they jealous of her. And guess who liked the post? Her good friend Cardi B. So if y'all ever wondering why they feel like this, it's partly because one, their parents were insecure and implanted that shit in them, making them think that they were better because they were light skinned, because their parents couldn't deal with the shit that they were dealing with at work. And two, they got men laying up, buying them cars and houses, telling them that all this shit is okay. But then that same man gets on IG Live and dogs they asses out because they weren't taught to be good people. They were only taught to be their skin color, okay? So that's why we have shit like this. Now I gotta go. Damn! Now, before I go and before I tell you what I'm drinking, all right, for you guys that have questions about expanding your wine tasting palette, I am personally partnered with the Tasting Room, okay? And you know I'm not going to sell you anything that I don't personally have and offer $9.95. They're going to ask you three simple questions. This does enter you into a membership. But for $9.95, they're going to curate six different bottles of little mini-wise from all over the world. And you're going to try wines that you probably would have never tried on your own, okay? It's an excellent membership, but if it's something you don't like, but I highly recommend it because I am a member and I get wine to my door every month, please cancel within 30 days. But for $9.95, you can't beat just trying out to see if it's something that you wouldn't mind subscribing to, okay? Like this channel. We'll talk about that in a minute. Now, for those of y'all that have questions about what I'm drinking, I introduced this the other day. This is the Scarborough Sauvignon Blanc grown in New Zealand, okay? And this wine tastes just as good as the damn bottle looks. Looks like kiwi fruit and shit, okay? Tastes a little kiwi, tastes a little lime, a little grapefruit, okay? Very crisp. Elegant. I love New Zealand wines. And I honestly paid around $9 for this bottle of wine here. And we're gonna be drinking this all damn week because honestly, it will complement any light food, such as a Greek salad or maybe some damn fresh avocado dip. Okay, it's a great lunch run. And I will leave the link below, okay, so that you can purchase this for yourself. And I also forgot to tell you that I will leave the link below to the Tasting Room, okay? That link is below the video, all right? Thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video, subscribe. You can also find me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat at Unwind with Tasha K. If you have tips on your favorite celebrities, please feel free to send me an email to unwindwithtashak@gmail.com. Or you can shoot me a text message to 404-382-8865, okay? And someone from my team will be right back with you, especially if it's a juicy ass story. And hell, if you didn't like this video, you can still subscribe anyway just so you can cuss my ass out. Not that I'm gonna really give a damn anyway. Now I gotta go. Bye.